Good morning, children. Today, let us study about how the name of our country, India, we have received. We know that our country has different names, India, Bharat, Hindustan, etc. How these names have come to our country, or how our country is named as India or Bharat. Two words we often use for our country, that is India and Bharat. The word India comes from the river Indus. This is also called the river Sindhu in Sanskrit language. This is the river Indus. We know that five tributaries of Indus river. Indus is the main river. It has five branches or five tributaries, mainly originating from Punjab. That's why Punjab is known as the land of five rivers. Then they all merge together into a single river, which is known as Indus and flowing through Pakistan now. So this name of India comes from the river Indus. Now, Iranians and the Greeks, we know that on this western part of India, okay, in the western region, Iranians and the Greeks who came to India through this northwestern region about 2500 years ago. They were very familiar with the river because they had to cross the river to enter India. Okay, for crossing the river Indus, they came to India. So they knew well about river Indus. They called Indus River as a Indus or these regions Indus and Hindus. So the land to the east of the river, this is the east of the river as the India. They called the land east of the river Indus, because Indus or Hindus, which they called, the Iranians or the Greeks called the river Indus as Indus or Hindus, and the regions lying to the east of the river Indus were called as India. Another name we know, that Bharat, India also is known as Bharat. Bharata was also a name used by the people who lived in the northwestern region, who mentioned about them. It is mentioned in the Rigveda. Rigveda, we know that it was the first Veda or the book written in our country in Sanskrit language. It's about 3500 years ago, and it was written. So in this book, Rigveda also is mentioned about our country as Bharat. So later it was used for the country. This Rigveda also we consider as one of our important book in the ancient past. So how do we find out all these things? Many of the books also mention about the past history of our India. From the ancient books we get many idea about our country. There are several ways to find out about our ancient culture, ancient past, or ancient glory of our country. One is to search for the reading books. Many years ago or before, which was written, there were no paper used in the ancient period. So the books were all written by hand. And also they used different methods for writing the books. No paper was invented. They used to write with hand. So that these are all known as manuscripts, which means handwritten. Manu is a word meaning hand. It's taken from Latin language. So that all the handwritten copies are, all the books are known as manuscripts. These also were usually written on palm leaves. Mostly palm leaves were used for writing. You know what the palm tree and palm leaves were. Also some other method they used to write on the bark of the birch tree. Birch tree, which is growing in the Himalayas. Birch tree, it's a bark. Bark means the outer skin. The thick outer skin of the birch tree also used to write the manuscripts. When many years passed, over the years passed, these manuscripts, as we know that many of them were eaten away by insects or destroyed. Many of them were destroyed by the insects and some of them survived. And which is available now, what were survived and which we can find out and we can read out. Often preserved, and many of these books were preserved in the temples and monasteries. Monasteries where the Buddhist monks live, the place where Buddhist monks live. Some of the books were preserved in the temples and monasteries so that it is available now. And these books were dealt with different kinds of subjects. What were the subjects these books were dealing with is especially religious beliefs and practices. What were the religions and their customs and traditions or religious practices were followed by the people in our country are mentioned in these books. Also other things, how the people lived, the lives of kings and medicine and science, these are all the different subjects dealt in these books. Besides this, there were also epics, itihasas or the epics like Ramayana and Mahabharata, poems, plays, all these are mentioned, all these books also available. Many of these are written in Sanskrit and some other books were written in Prakrit languages also, that is a language spoken by the ordinary people. Many books were written in Sanskrit and some of them were written in Prakrit language, common language of the people. Some books in the ancient period we can find out even in Tamil also.